Good morning, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome back to my WWE 2K23 Universe Merch Man Puzzle Clapping live coverage. And we're here today with NXT new champion, of course, in Rara, or Goomba, begging my pardon, should be on the show some point. And we've got Ilya Dragunov in the main event, of course, as per usual. And we've got a start off for the show with Cactus Jack versus The Rock. Women's title here, Alba Fire, and like a fifth attempt to try and get it off Gigi Dolan, fourth, begging my pardon. Well, fifth, actually, yeah, it is. A fifth attempt to try and get the title. Going against Gigi Dolan again. Zoe Stark, Kane and Carter continuing the rivalry, as do Rey Mysterio Jr. and Mr. McMahon, JD McDonagh, along with Razor Ramon. Now then, Wesley is taking on Andre the Bloody Giant. Crying out loud, how the hell's going to win that one? Axiom becoming Goomba's first North American Championship challenger. Then we've got Bruno Sammartino and the Macho Man, Randy Savage, in one hell of a little bloody co-main event. And then, of course, you've got Dragunov and Kevin Nash. Match one, the lunatic psycho that is Cactus Jack is going one-on-one with the great one. Ironically, it's going to be The Rock and Mick Foley, which is another little cheeky narrative there, to be fair. Great friends in real life, of course. Great respect for each other in the wrestling community for the two of them. And by the wrestling community as well. Just want to throw that out there. But it's going to be Cactus Jack and The Rock opening NXT next.
The following is scheduled for one fall, making his way to the ring from Truth or Consequences, New Mexico, weighing in at 287 pounds, Cactus Jack!
Think about the history of Cactus Jack, whose origins date back to both ECW and WCW, where he won tag team titles in both organizations.
I think you meant origins, Saxton, but I understand everyone's a little on edge when Cactus Jack's around.
How'd you know?
What I want to know is who would team with a man this dangerous? And when you're dealing with Cactus Jack, the rules are more like light suggestions.
Example of a man who was destined for success the moment he stepped foot in WWE.
Somehow, Corey, he exceeded those expectations. Now he's the most popular celebrity in the entire planet.
Yeah, despite his non-stop schedule, The Rock still makes time to lay the smack down.
The Rock creates unforgettable moments each and every time he steps into a WWE ring.
Man, how lucky are we to get to see The Rock do what The Rock does best?
Saxton, you're lucky The Rock's letting you call this match. Out of his damn mind. He has to be the most feared of Mick Foley's fractured psyche.
No argument from me there, Corey. We'll have to see how long this lasts before things get extreme.
Yeah, but The Rock isn't all flash and no substance. He was born into the business. And while that could have allowed him to just rest on his laurels, he didn't.
Saxton's right. You can't deny the fact that when it comes to electrifying the millions and millions of
his fans, The Rock made damn sure he was able to do that both in and out of the ring. What we're going to see here tonight should be a reminder to anyone foolish enough to doubt the abilities of the great one.
The only thing louder than The Rock's mouth and personality is his explosiveness in the ring. When you're standing in the ring against him, the last thing you want to do is allow him to really get cooking. If you can, break The Rock down with the ground and pound. Refuse to let him breathe. That will change the entire complexion of this match.
Looks like that disrupted The Rock's typically dazzling style.
Getting a look at how volatile Jack can truly be.
Placed elbow to the leg.
A non-stop assault from Jack here.
And he's really been doing his best to cut The Rock off at the pass here. Not letting him breathe. Refusing to let him get back into this.
Getting set up for something in the corner.
Cactus Jack.
Oh, no. Cactus showing. And there's the cover.
He got it. No. The Rock barely kicked out.
As close to three as you could possibly get without the bell ringing.
And The Rock is finally changing the tempo with that attack.
Prime opportunity now for him to get some separation and gather himself.
Some damage already.
Sleeper hold cinched in.
And he's just in reach of the ropes and gets it to force the break.
The ropes become a competitor's best friend in desperate moments like that one.
He has the answer for The Rock. Gets out of there in a hurry. He's heading to the floor, but he can't take his time. Able to interrupt the attack. And this might not have a pleasant ending. Cactus Jack is having problems here.
This is Cactus's perseverance being tested.
And he throws the opposition back into the ring. The Rock is heading up top.
From the top!
Elbow drop! Good lord!
Drops the hammer. Right on the lower back.
He's heading up top!
Thinking big!
Oh! The top! A diving hammer strike! The Great One has become relentless.
Showing exactly why he's the Great One.
And Cactus expected that.
Boom, nice. He's turning the tables.
There it is. The Rock got all of it.
Is it enough? The cover. An exhausting victory, but a win nonetheless.
Here is your winner, The Rock.
And the Great One picks up the victory this morning on NXT.
He can still electrify.
What an amazing match that was for The Rock. Cactus Jack just looked timid. Gotta be honest, he didn't look himself. There wasn't any of the kind of killer instinct that we've seen earlier in the series. Jack just looks like a shadow of where he was, actually. Good match by The Rock, though. 3.5 star, kicking us off with NXT nicely. Pardon me, guys, begging my pardon. And here we go. Alba Fire taking on the champion again. She's not had any joy against this in this matchup so far. She came pretty close last time, to be fair, last week. But clearly we need some spice added to the top of the NXT women's division. It could happen. It could happen, I suppose, the CWF. You may see Whisper move up, but Alba Fire challenges Gigi Dolan again. Match 2, NXT Women's Championship. Let's go.
She calls herself the young veteran, Alba Fire.
A woman with plenty of accolades, and she's just getting started.
Titles in nearly every major women's division, the longest reigning NXT UK women's champion.
She calls herself the forever champion, and she has indeed earned that moniker. A woman descended from generations of warriors. Fighting is in her blood. And there is fire in her eyes that cannot be extinguished.
The self-proclaimed Hell's Favorite Harlot.
And you can see exactly why. A woman who began her wrestling career at the age of 17 years old.
Yeah, she's one of the youngest female competitors in WWE, but already has a veteran's mindset. Don't let the looks fool you. Dolan can be as tough as nails in the ring.
And with Toxic Attraction by her side, nothing can stop her.
The following contest is scheduled for 1-4 and is for the NXT Women's Championship. Introducing the challenger from Glasgow, Scotland, Alba Fire. And her opponent from Atlanta, Georgia, she is the NXT Women's Champion, Gigi Dolan.
You win this title, you are a top name in this industry.
The imposing aerial threat, Alba Fire, looking for a big win here tonight.
Already a world-traveled competitor, Fire possesses an incredible array of innovative daredevil attacks. But don't let that fool you, Cole. Fire can get down and dirty with the best.
And let's hope she knows how to bottle up that attitude and put it to good use here.
And let's not forget about Gigi Dolan. This is a woman who knows what she wants and sets out to take it every time that bell rings. This is a woman with drive, gentlemen.
Yeah, no matter the cause, Corey, Dolan definitely has a sense of entitlement about her. And that is
from the top. Diving elbow drop, are you kidding me? Cover. Two count. The champion's still in the fight.
She just dodged a major bullet.
Look out.
Oh, God, that's a bad landing.
Wildly throwing your body out of the ring like that is more often than not gonna provide such a result.
That was an example of boldness backfiring.
Oh, man, they do not care who or what they destroy.
Yeah, Byron, you are dangerously close to being collateral damage in this one.
Alba Fyre absolutely lives up to the name, but I have a feeling that cooler heads might just prevail in this one. If Fyre wants a better chance of coming out of this one with a W, she has to keep her wits about her and not let her emotions take control.
A smart strategy. Fyre's few losses have come because of mistakes made due for the title. She breaks the count quick.
She still has enough energy for a simple kick out.
Fighting back with a counter. Beautiful athleticism.
She did her homework there.
Apply an agonizing armbar stretch.
Punishing stretch.
That could produce a dislocation or at the very least, a pinched nerve.
Up and shoulders down now. Is it enough to retain the championship?
Stops the count before it too.
Not yet. Vicious forearm right in the skull. And Gigi didn't see that coming. Dolan finding an opening.
And look at this now, yes, applying the submission hold.
Black Widow.
Locked in tight.
Almost a miraculous escape and a side slam.
Arm sister, look at these vicious kicks to the jaw.
The challenger not looking good right now.
Yeah, but you can't count anyone out yet. This match could still go either way.
Up the rope, beautiful, all the way down to the outside.
That's finding any which way to topple the competition.
Hurling your own body like that is insane.
Snap suplex. Basement drop kick.
Oh my goodness.
Oh, what a smash.
That is just insulting.
Oh, look at this.
Is really gaining the momentum now.
And that's what happens when Alba Fyre centers herself and doesn't let her emotions steer the ship. She's focused and absolutely dominating right now.
Oh my goodness. She had it scouted. She re-enters the ring now. Talk about it.
Gigi Dolan has her opponent up.
Oh, the Gigi Driver.
Another one bites the dust to the champ.
Not only did Gigi Dolan pick up the win, she also retained possession of her title.
Here is your winner.
If we needed any more clarification, ladies and gentlemen, Alba Fyre is not on Gigi Dolan's level.
And she walks away with a big win.
What a performance.
This one could have really gone either way, but the end result just goes to show you what a combination of opportunity.
I don't agree with Corey Graves there, unfortunately. I don't. Alba Fyre can look as impressive as she wants, but she has. Gigi's got a number. Absolutely got a number all across the board. And now we get back into the rivalries, guys. NXT's rivalries will be changing in 2 months. So we've got another 8 weeks of these matches. Oh, pardon me, guys. Begging my pardon. I provoked attack once again. Zoe Stark taking on Kayden Carter. These two have been in and out of action between each other. It's been a very, very interesting little rivalry, this, actually. Kind of 50-50 booking all across the board. Some really exciting angles. Some less than exciting ones as well. We've got to kind of get out of the rough. We've got to this move without the rough, of course. But Zombie Stark and Kayden Carter, it's going to be an amazing blowout match. Match three, let's go.
Cocky and confident, but listening to the other superstar already talk trash.
You can just tell how much disdain is between both these competitors.
Enough flapping your gums. Oh. It's time to throw hands.
Match hasn't even started. Official trying to gain control.
Yeah, good luck with that.
We're going to need more than one referee out here for this. And we need to get some officials out here to get some semblance of order.
There's the bell to this highly anticipated match. So anticipated, these combatants couldn't even wait for the bell.
This match is a powder keg, ready to blow. Emotions are running very high between these superstars.
Well, that's one explanation for the unchecked violence we witnessed before the bell.
And now thrown back into the ring. Oh, man, face buster. Caden Carter certainly isn't one of the biggest competitors in WWE. That has to put her at a bit of a disadvantage here, doesn't it, Corey?
While she might not be the biggest superstar, Cole, she knows how to use leverage to her benefit. Carter's achieved a lot despite her smaller stature, and that's because she learned how to succeed with what she has.
Lands face first.
No way.
High risk cross body.
That's playing fast and loose with your own body.
That is weaponizing your body. That's what that was.
Oh, I hope they back up. They're getting too close for comfort.
Well, no one's paying attention to you, Saxon. They're too busy beating the tar out of each other.
Producing a trampling. Plenty of hits coming her way now. Taking the fight near our announce table.
I really hope we get these desks at a discount.
And back into the ring she goes. The ref still counting. Might be a count out. Beat the count back in. This one will continue. Into the corner now.
Wrist lock. Climbing the ropes. Into the...
Will this be enough?
That could have gone either way.
Tremendous pressure being applied in this head crank.
Oh, man. Looks like her opponent's not going to need a chiropractor.
Things have been fraught between these competitors for weeks. But you have to notice how tensions have risen even more recently. Nothing seems to be off limits at this point, and that's not a good thing.
Stopping the leg. Just nasty.
Oh, saw it coming. Now bad intentions coming with this hold. Abdominal stretch. It's luck.
Well, I'm not sure she can escape out of this. And yes, she does.
Turns the tides. Boom. Head kick connects.
Turnbuckle's the only thing keeping her upright.
Counter from Stark.
When you think it's the end, she stays alive.
What amazing resilience. Is this the start of a comeback?
I don't know if there's more frustration or desperation in the ring now.
Look at the height through the air and connects.
And that was a collision you don't want to be on the receiving end of.
Came down like a wrecking ball on a cinder block. Pinning down their opponent's arm. And a carefully measured knee drop.
She's taking a beating here.
There's been plenty of action in this match, and the cost of that is really showing now.
She throws her back in.
She's going up.
Top rope here. From the top. She comes up empty. Become relentless.
Zoe's turning it up now.
Finds a counter from Stark.
Momentum isn't completely out of Caden's side just yet.
Time now for Caden to get her energy up, and
she got the shoulders down. And she thwarts the pin attempt in one.
Amazing effort by her.
Seated drop kick connects.
Both arms captured. And vitriolic stomps.
And another just non-stop aggression.
Picks the leg of their opponent, steps through. Here we go. Rolling deathlock.
Rolling deathlock. This would be an amazing. And she escapes the submission.
Seems like Zoe Stark has really, really found a rhythm against Kaden Carter. Took a bit of a beating at the start for Zoe. Kaden seemed to have the upper hand, but once she got the power in, started to use a bit of her own pace as well. Kaden's obviously very, very fast, quick as a Whippet character. But as soon as Zoe got into rhythm, Kaden had no answer. And this proves it, of course. Very nice match, very fun match. Restart, let's go. I think these guys are almost ready to, these ladies back upon are almost ready to move on to new things now, I'd imagine, wouldn't you? But here we go. Speaking of new things, can we please get off this fucking feud? Provoked attack. Rey Mysterio and Mr. McMahon are still fucking feuding and will still be feuding for the next two bastard months. For love of Lord. It's like the biggest rivalries in history, isn't it? But it's Rey Mysterio Jr., who, of course, attacked Mr. McMahon last week, I seem to remember, didn't he? Let me have a look at it. He did. He attacked Mr. McMahon and Cruz del Toro. This is interesting. Will Mysterio and Cruz have a little fight after this? You never know. Mysterio Jr. and Mr. McMahon match four next.
Cocky and confident, but listening to the other superstar already talk trash.
You can just tell how much disdain is between both these competitors.
Enough flapping your gums. Oh. Our time to throw hands.
Match hasn't even started. Official trying to gain control.
Yeah, good luck with that.
We're going to need more than one referee out here for this.
These two just could not hold themselves back.
Emotions running high in this highly anticipated match, but this is officially underway.
And you know, I just hope we have a clean fight here moving forward.
I'm not sure you should get your hopes up. If that starts anything to go by, we are in for a drag-out slugfest here.
Placing them right where they want them, into the corner, and Ray capitalizes there.
Ducked face first!
Spinning kick to the gut. What a clothesline!
Ouch! Really just laying it in.
Just a barrage of strikes. Just a series of hard shots. Ooh, cheap shot right above the eye. Side headlock applied. Ooh, and a right hand for good measure. Into cover. Oh, he kicked out.
And frustration might be starting to set in.
Corey, how do you think this guy matches up with Mr. McMahon?
Well, Mr. McMahon obviously has this match in the bag, and you know why, Cole? Just look at him, that Adonis-like body.
No! Slingshot senton, yes!
Just exhibiting their fearlessness.
Exhibiting guts and accuracy as well.
Turned that one around. Finds a counter for Mr. McMahon.
Connects with the kick.
Battling at ringside can be very unforgiving. You have to be careful out there.
No protection out here. No safe confines to speak of.
Make it over. Standing Shiranui.
Sometimes you just gotta show off and show out.
Gets put into the barricade.
Comes back into the ring. Springboard into a...
Are you kidding me?
Absolutely throwing all caution to the wind.
Spinning in the face of danger. Lots of potential for injury here at ringside. These superstars better be careful.
The floor, the barricades, our table. None of these things are fun to collide with.
Mr. McMahon is really being knocked around here.
Yeah, Mr. McMahon has to find a response quickly.
Taking their lumps at this point. Their opponent is not messing around.
Guys, truly, I need to know, when will enough be enough? When is this going to end? They truly want to rip each other apart.
I think you just answered your own question. This doesn't end until they rip each other apart. There's no happy ending to this rivalry. There is no saving grace.
He eludes the contact. Snapmare
and a basement drop kick.
I don't like the look in his eye here, folks.
Another big move.
Mysterio might have this wrapped up.
Two.
Finally ends it, and all the bloodshed perhaps worth it now.
Here is your winner. And the results are becoming more and more expected in this feud. Mr. McMahon had a very, very hot start to it. This has been all Mysterio.
Mr.
Mysterio, I've got to be honest, he's getting a little bit more aggressive over recent weeks.
And some killer instinct, but what a win.
Maybe not the words I would have chosen for describing how they pulled this off, but yeah, they won.
Another three-star match, guys. This hasn't been the best NXT so far, I've got to be honest. But yeah, we'll keep persevering. Now, this one usually does help perk up the ratings and the statistics. It is JD McDonagh taking on Razor Ramon, I believe. And it's all the same fucking ones. God, come on. We need a bit more variety in this, guys. Come on, seriously. Three views. Oh, thank you very much for watching. This has been a dot. This is honest to God. Been part of one of NXT's, other than the opener. The opener was really fun between The Rock and Cactus Jack. But even then, it was pretty just like, meh. These two usually do throw up a banger. So we will see. JD McDonagh vs. Ramon, match 5 next.
I actually like this because the trash talking's already started.
It is very clear these superstars do not like each other.
Oh, we're not going to wait any longer. The match hasn't even started yet.
And these superstars couldn't care less.
This is personal.
These two just want to tear each other apart. I'm not sure the referee is going to get control.
Clearly a lot of hostile feelings between these superstars who couldn't even wait for the match to begin before getting their hands on each other.
Certainly a very dramatic start to this contest. Just goes to show how intense this match is going to be.
Yeah, clearly this fight has been a long time coming, and now there is no more holding back.
Oh, no. Now possibly setting up for a submission maneuver.
Able to give him the slip.
Get him into the corner. Clothesline in the corner. Oh, that was just malicious.
Just disrespectful.
Crushing the knee there. Oh, he retaliates. Double stomp. There are a few athletes that possess the size, speed, and agility of Razor Ramon. That trifecta has to be tough for any opponent facing off against the bad guy.
Well, Ramon uses all of those skills with his signature strikes that can drop anyone in a second. If Razor's opponent can avoid or even withstand those haymakers, he'll be in a much better position.
Drops the hammer.
Right on the lower back.
Into the ring again.
Spectacular athleticism.
Adding a little flair to a damaging impact. Quite the showmanship.
Close to over.
Oh, look at strike.
Razor gets countered. Elbow smash. Ireland's J.D. McDonough.
Ramon looks out of it.
Two. And a kick out.
Had to dig deep to break that pin.
But can it be done again? How much is left after that?
It is unreal that this match is still going on after a maneuver that would end most matches.
It has been so exciting to watch this rivalry unfold. There's nothing these superstars want more than to defeat each other.
I don't think you can even call this a rivalry anymore.
It's more like an all-out war.
It certainly goes well beyond anything we've seen before. Big hook! Planning on what to do next.
Holy, that was an awful landing.
And countouts are legal, so hopefully this will be a short trip outside.
Invert an atomic drop.
Ooh. Gentlemen, in the interest of self-preservation, I may have to excuse myself. Saxton, you hang tight. Let this play out.
Outside of the ring now.
What's the plan here?
McDonough wasting no motion on the counter.
Oh, man, just punishing.
And Razor's leaving no breathing room here.
Just unrelenting attacks from the bad guy.
Could be some collateral damage on the way here.
Everyone needs to clear out, including us.
Sidewalk slam!
Almost drove him through the ring.
Brought back into the ring from the floor now. He may not be aware of the count. He's got to get back in. He climbs back into the ring just in time.
That was getting close.
Wrenches the arm.
Ooh, nasty kick.
Consecutive attacks keeping McDonough off his game.
This could be it.
Cover for the win.
You've got to be kidding me.
What an incredible match we are witnessing.
A bad guy looking to end this now. Here it comes.
Water drag provides an escape.
McDonough hoping to
he could be looking for a submission here. Abdominal stretch. It's locked in. Abdominal stretch. Fighting out. That's one way to get out of it.
Oh, this is just too far. Get some control in there.
Oh, look at his aggression. Just pure brutality.
Come on, easy. The bad guy has his opponent. And down with the choke slam.
Here comes Byron. Oh. Look at the height.
It is. Razor's edge.
Razor's put a lot of competitors out with that.
Makes a cover.
Somehow he kicked out.
Can you imagine how much escaping that pin must have cost him?
I can't. These are the moments where you really fight out how tough you are.
What's the tally on how many times we thought this match was coming to an end? I hold on a second. Could be a matter of time. Submission being locked in.
Oh, here it is, the abdominal stretch.
Grabbing the ankle for extra torque.
Ooh. I'm not quite sure if this man shouldn't tap out.
This is about career longevity, self-preservation. Tap out and fight again.
Sharp elbows.
And a head toss to escape.
These competitors have been unloading on each other since the bell, just looking for that window of opportunity.
And now might be the time to seize the moment. Now.
Ireland's call for McDonough.
Now, McDonough needs to end this.
Wait, are you sure that was not a three count?
You can't count that high, Saxton, but that was one of the closest near falls you'll ever see.
I can't tell if it's anger in the eyes of the fact that he hasn't finished this, or if it's disbelief that his opponent is still in this. There's electricity running through this arena right now.
Will it be the spark for one of these competitors?
Driven down face first.
My goodness, is this even legal?
I don't think so.
Oh, look at this ruthlessness in the bottom turnbuckle.
Great counter.
Look at this, going counter.
see it. Way up there.
Razor's Edge. Is that all she wrote for McDonough?
And there's the win. Huge win here tonight.
Here is your winner, the Bad.
Well, it certainly is the
Razor.
What is that? I'm going to address that in a minute. It is Razor's one of his biggest wins of the series.
This was on display in this one.
It took two Razor fucking Razors just to beat him. Thank you for the follow, but no. Why would I want that? So many fucking frauds, guys. So many fucking goddamn fake-ass accounts. Scammers. It's like Logan Paul's been shagging Africans, isn't it? I mean, Jesus fucking Christ. Stop scamming. No, why would I want that? A random is going to change my life jumping in and fucking offering me a scam deal. Fuck off. Fucking idiots. But cheers for the follow, the extra number. Can't wait till you get fucking deleted. Awesome. Cunt. Right, here we go then. Match 6. Very interesting little avenue and angle this. It is Andre Giant, who's not lost a match since Bobby the Brain Heenan took over as his manager, going up against Wesley. Will they be able to follow on from an incredible match between Ramon and JD McDonagh? Those two boys, they do put good shows on, in fairness to them. But Wesley, former NXT North American champion, bit of a mishmash of form, looking to try and climb up towards JD, or it could be Razor, of course, depending who the champion's going to be. But it's Wesley, Andre the Giant, match 6. Let's go.
Here's an extremely impressive young high flyer.
The following is scheduled for 1 fall, making his way to the ring from Dayton, Ohio, weighing in at 183 pounds, Wesley!
Served in the United States Air Force.
Wesley is definitely right at home when taking to the skies. Wesley has acquired his target here tonight. Guys, this is going to be fun to watch.
X marks the spot for Wesley. Behold the unbelievable presence that is the eighth wonder of the world, Andre the Giant,
the true meaning of a larger-than-life superstar.
And his opponent, accompanied by Bobby Heenan from Grenoble, France, weighing in at 520 pounds, the eighth wonder of the world, Andre the Giant!
You want to talk about dominance from Andre the Giant? How about his 15-year undefeated streak in WWE.
I think we're in the midst of another streak, Saxton.
Look at the size of Andre the Giant. I hope to reinforce the ring tonight.
That might not be enough. And here's the first WWE Hall of Fame inductee.
There is no one more deserving of that honor.
To say that Wesley is a spectacle in the ring might be an understatement. His offense is on a level that is rarely seen in sports entertainment.
There is no denying that Lee is an incredible amalgamation of some of the sport's greatest high flyers of all time. His offense is innovation at its finest.
Well said, Byron. I think we're all looking forward to seeing what Lee pulls out in this match.
But across the ring, you have a man who's the odds-on favorite in any match. Andre the Giant, a competitor who's not only bigger and stronger than almost anyone in the history of WWE, but who has traveled the world proving he's is the most extraordinary athlete of all time.
You don't get to be the eighth wonder of the world without conquering the globe, and Andre's done just that. A running Dragon Rana. Wow! Corkscrew moonsault, beautiful! From the middle rope, Brown taking Hurricane Rana. Stomp in the leg.
It's always amazing to watch Andre the Giant. All this incredible athlete needs to do to win is put his world-renowned physicality.
For the victory here.
And Ellie stays down for a one count.
We are this far into the match. Where is this energy coming from?
Perhaps thinking about what to do next here. Straight impact down the throat. Drops the hammer
right on the lower back.
Closed fist punch to the jaw. That's one way to break up a move.
Heads outside, but this one has to end in the ring.
One. Incredible power slam.
Battling ringside, and our announce table's getting shaky.
That's because Byron is quivering in fear next to me.
I get nervous when the fight comes out here, guys.
This match's brutality starting to show on him.
Not a bad place to be in, but the longer this goes, the more trouble a superstar exposes himself to.
Right forearm.
Head scissor. And he wants nothing to do with any of that. Taking a trip outside, but he's got to be mindful of the count.
And he gets delivered back into the ring. Wards off that offense from West.
Oh, look at the squeeze. It's on like a vice grip.
Oh, that just looks nasty.
Oh, man.
Clearly waiting for that.
Caught with the boot. Andre might never have experienced a blow like that one.
There's that innovative West Lee offense catching you off guard.
Heel hook. Look at this. Oh, that's so painful.
It's hard to watch, too.
Got him set up in the corner of the ring.
Out to the back of the neck, sends their opponent to the middle of the ring. Handstand into a Pele kick. West with a big-time move.
The cover!
Andre still able to kick out there. Incredible.
How?
And Andre expected that.
What a drop kick.
My goodness, look at this buffalo strike. Does he have him here? He kicks out at two.
There's some shock in the arena after that kick out.
And that was a well-executed attack. Oh, look at the well-placed elbow right on the mark. And the pressure on Andre continues to mount.
We're seeing Andre in an unusual tough spot.
Coming in hot at breakneck speed.
Going fast and living dangerously.
Run out of ringside and back to the mat.
And he said, you're not getting me with that this time.
Double arm lock. Yeah, double arm lock, sir.
sent right into the corner. Reversal. Can they go on the attack?
Each superstar trying to stay a step ahead.
Oh, the Giant answers back. He turns it around. A snapmare.
Wesley put in a phenomenal effort. He tried. He really, really tried. But Andre the Giant with Bobby the Brain Heenan is another commodity. Yeah, Wesley didn't stand much of a chance. But now, match 7, ladies and gentlemen, is one that a lot of the kind of casuals would be kind of more interested in, because this is the first created superstar to win a championship outside of the Created Wrestler show. Very, very intriguing this. We will see how this goes. Axiom is Goomba's challenger. Match 7 is next.
A technical wizard, a high-flying genius. Here comes Axiom.
A mathematical savant who claims everything in the ring can be solved by equations.
Given his success thus far, he may have the numbers right.
Time to see if the calculations are correct for Axiom.
Corey, what do you think of the champ's chances here tonight?
I love him. I'm not like everybody else, Cole. It seems like everybody's ready to write the champ's demise, but not me. Many are predicting a title change here tonight, but this man is looking to prove otherwise.
Thank you.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall and is for the NXT North American Championship. Introducing the challenger from Madrid, Spain, weighing in at 154 pounds, Axiom. And his opponent from London, England, weighing in at 215 pounds, he is the NXT North American Champion, Brian Jones.
Here we go. This is what it's all about. The NXT North American Championship is on the line.
The NXT North American title stole the show in its inaugural ladder match and has only become even more coveted in the years since its introduction.
Well, it's easy to see why, Michael. NXT has some of the fiercest competitors in the world, and hey, the title looks pretty cool too.
Off into the pin.
And those kickouts are only gonna get harder.
Going for a pin for the championship.
Oh my, how in the world did he kick out of that?
Not time to expect victory yet.
The champion's down, the champion's down.
Oh my God, we're gonna have a new champion. He's nowhere near ready to stop fighting yet.
Effective cover by the champ.
And a shoulder in the air.
He's far from finished.
Connects on the kick.
Corey, it has to be hard for Axiom to take on opponents when most of them have a size and strength advantage.
It ain't easy, Cole, but it's not impossible.
Axiom possesses an incredible calculating mind that he uses in every attack. That means there's no wasted energy when Axiom starts rolling, and that's hard for anyone to overcome, no matter how big they are.
He's got him scouted.
Catches the clothesline.
Into a Spanish fly!
Carefully placed stomp to the arm.
Has the leg trapped. Fisherman suplex.
That'll win your battle.
Punishing stretch.
Momentum is pivoted toward Axiom. Yeah, that's what I was saying, Cole. Axiom using that mind of his to get things done with no wasted energy.
Hoist it up for the stun gun, neckbreaker.
Continuing to work on the arm with a
drop in the knee for more punishment.
Oh, the elbow connects. Look out! Oh no, crashing hard onto the floor.
That was an absolutely haphazard, uncalculated risk.
And I have no doubt they're going to pay dearly for it.
Vicious right forearm. Has the leg trapped. Fisherman suplex.
And Axiom got turned around there.
Round and around we go. Tilt-a-whirl head scissors.
Toss back into the ring.
Head scissors.
Round and round we go.
Innovative offensive display there. A bad place to be for the challenger.
Yeah, but you can't count anyone out yet. This match could still go either way.
Take off.
Straight to the face, stays off the attack.
He is delivering elbow after elbow.
Oh, what a man run.
It's incredible the inventiveness we are seeing on display here.
from the top rope.
Axiom reverses.
That was a shining wizard.
Gets propelled.
Drop throat first across the top.
And he sends him into the corner.
Ooh, there's the kick. Second row.
Followed by
sunrise.
The title's going nowhere. Kiss your dreams. Good night.
Here is your winner, and still NXT North American Champion, Ryan Jones.
He definitely got the job done tonight.
This win is going to have them on a high for quite some time, I have to believe.
Winning's great, Saxton, but they have to start thinking about their next challenge sooner rather than later. This win won't be all that matters much longer.
The living legend.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall, making his way to the ring from Abruzzo, Italy, weighing in at 265 pounds, the first superstar, Bruno Sammartino.
The man who sold out the world's most famous arena 187 times.
Looks like he sold out this place too, Corey.
The pride of Italy, perhaps the greatest pro wrestler of all time.
Well, Michael, I think his championship reigns certainly back up that claim.
Look who's here. The cream of the crop has arrived.
And his opponent, from Sarasota, Florida, weighing in at 239 pounds, Macho Man Randy Savage.
One of the most important superstars in the history of our industry, the Macho Man Randy Savage.
And the Macho Man, notoriously intense inside the ring, but extremely giving outside of it. A true superstar in every sense of the word. Listen to these people. The Macho Man has the entire WWE Universe in the palm of his hand.
Nobody quite like the Macho Man. Before all the glory, Bruno Sammartino had a hard upbringing. Fleeing conflict in his home country of Italy, he came to America, to Pittsburgh, to pursue his dreams.
It's the true American success story. Through hard work and incredible determination, Bruno became a once-in-a-lifetime talent. He never let go of his dream, and he made it happen.
And some more hard work might be all it takes for Bruno to notch another win here.
And on the other end, make no mistake about it, Savage is legit. But my question is, will he be able to stay focused and not get distracted by outside agitators?
I think that's much to do about nothing, Corey. Macho Man is like a heat-seeking missile. He always stays locked in on his target with unreal tenacity.
Ooh.
to the leg.
He just barely dodges.
Back and forth from these competitors.
Oh, atomic drop!
Well-timed counter on Sammartino.
What a punch! You know, Bruno favors a more traditional pace inside the ring, so controlling the tempo here is critical. If Bruno gets caught in a fast-paced, flashy match, things could be difficult for him.
That's right, Corey. An old-school competitor like Sammartino is definitely going to want things to be much more methodical inside the ring.
Bam! Down he goes.
Fight is so close to our announce table.
Yeah, I'm just going to step aside now.
Hey, wait for me! Atomic drop! Ooh! Big-time atomic drop!
That'll have you walking funny.
Up and down! What a slam!
Elbow drop!
Piercing.
He's in a little bit of trouble now.
They've definitely taken
from the top.
Oh, and he doesn't connect. Oh, clubbing blow to the back. Strong right. Now that'll do some serious damage.
Oh, meet the backside of an elbow.
His aggression, just pure brutality.
Come on, easy. Boom! The Macho Man is just begging for a fight.
Nice side headlock applied.
Oh, very good measure.
Able to sidestep it.
Big clothesline.
Sammartino with a nice turnaround.
Oh, what a right hook.
Getting carried. Unsure what they're thinking. Goes under the ropes to get back inside. He's going for it all.
Launching.
He misses the target.
Short flight, but a rough landing.
Sammartino's focused. He's zoned in.
Well-timed counter on Sammartino.
Down he goes.
I don't know how there's anything left in these superstars' bodies. Savage now perched high atop the ropes.
Drop by the Macho Man.
Terrible position for Sammartino.
Returning to the ring now.
What are they doing here?
Jarring impact.
Just punched him right in the mouth. Relentless. Right in the face.
My God.
Able to reverse that one.
Dropped him with a big shoulder tackle. Oh, wicked kick to the lower back.
Kick to the gut creates separation.
Ooh, stiff punch.
Headlock. Ooh, cheap shot right above the eye. Oh, and a double axe handle. Incredible height.
The Macho Man Randy Savage. What is he planning?
Oh my God! A sprint for the win.
Here is your winner, Macho Man Randy Savage.
Shout out to Goomba for winning and defending the North American Championship, and what a match for Randy Savage. Awesome match, that one. With a load of mediocrity in the show so far, but that was a belter. Well done, Randy Savage, beating the greatest of all time, the original GOAT, shall we say, Bruno Sammartino. That was a terrible roll of the R then as well, by the way. The way it's going, guys, I will be able to have enough time to do the third stream as well, so I'm going to go and get the socials updated for a 12:30 start, potentially. I think I'm going to do that. Right then, Ilya Dragunov and Kevin Nash once again. It's a monster, so it's going to be a different opponent. Oh, nice. Cruz del Toro getting himself some more exposure. Good to see for Cruz, get himself in there, get himself out there as well. Bit of hokey-cokey there. Bit of a different change of pace for opponent. Probably aiming to take on Kevin Nash. And he's got himself a rapid Lucha Libre star, Cruz del Toro. In this game, one third of Legado del Fantasma. Main event of NXT, Dragunov and Cruz. Let's go.
The following contest is scheduled for 1-4, making his way to the ring from Moscow, Russia, weighing in at 187 pounds, Ilya Dragunov!
You are looking at one of the hardest hitting competitors in NXT history, a man who's ready to unleash fury on the entire WWE roster.
Often called the Czar of NXT.
Right now, Ilya Dragunov looking to expand his power to all of WWE.
Well, this man has proven to be quite the impressive lucha competitor.
But with a newfound killer instinct.
And his opponent, representing Legado del Fantasma from Cordoba, Veracruz, Mexico, weighing in at 190 pounds, Cruz del Toro!
Cruz del Toro has a new attitude that some would say has lit a fuse in him.
Yeah, now Del Toro does things his own way.
Well, he made his debut at 15 years old, over a decade wrestling in Mexico and Japan.
He brings his devastating hybrid of lucha libre and technical skills to every match he competes in.
Ilya Dragunov ready to bring his aggressive style to his opponent here tonight.
Dragunov has to be one of the toughest competitors in WWE. Few can match his intense and relentless approach to competition. I don't know how he manages it, but Ilya Dragunov always seems to be on the attack, even when being attacked.
Certainly a dangerous competitor for anyone who's...
It could be over here!
This is it!
What do you have to do to put this guy away?
Thanks for coming.
And it looks like Dragunov is bleeding after that.
Absolutely spiked.
DDT.
A defiant kick out after one.
Still gonna take a massive effort to keep him down.
Quick thinking from Dragunov. And for Ilya Dragunov, it is about that philosophy. Umbazikbar. The notion that he's undefeatable once he reaches a certain point. The question is, how does he get there?
Well, it's this simple for Ilya Dragunov. Just keep fighting. Dragunov fights every day to prove his worth. Umbazikbar isn't just something that sounds scary, it's something he's earned the right to call himself.
Into the corner. This can't be good. Damon Gary! Wow!
Boom. He's getting a little battered now.
Executed.
Answering back. He's going for the pin. This could be it. Fights the shoulder up in one.
Still has a great amount of fight in them. Not going to let it end like this. Oh.
Setting up. For the pin and the win.
Yes.
He breaks the ref's count before two.
All the punishment he's taken, and yet he's still on this match. Powerbomb.
He leaves the ring, but he could lose this match by countout.
Into the schoolboy. Wait,
that's not it. Suplex. Step back and measuring his opponent.
He went right into that turnbuckle.
And that holds Dragunov back.
From the middle rope.
Oh, wait a second. Caught in
the air. A sit-up powerbomb.
He's absorbing some tough hits now.
And the intensity in every move Dragunov delivers doesn't seem to be wavering one bit.
Ooh.
And Dragunov is showcasing his arsenal.
And Dragunov showing that Umbazikbar truly makes him unstoppable. Ooh.
This epic robbery began like any other, with jealousy and harsh words.
But from that seed has blossomed an all-time blood feud.
Yeah, and who could have predicted when all this began that they...
Del Toro and Segura.
Del Toro has him staring at the lights.
Kick out. I thought it was finished off for sure.
The amount of damage Dragunov can and will take in any given match is unbelievable. And we are seeing that right now. He is still in
rope step. Oh, God! Out of
don't care how bold you are, missing on those kind of maneuvers will send you to a medical facility.
A medical attention might be needed out here. That was a nasty landing.
To the back of the neck, Scottish Sickle.
And gets tossed back into the mat.
Climbing up top, he's got big plans. From the top, diving headbutt finds the mark.
He saw it coming, taking advantage. Oh, and Ilya turns the tables.
Del Toro out of harm's way.
Bad predicament right here. He's finding himself in trouble here.
Yeah, he's got to dig deep and find another win if he wants to stay in this.
Oh, catches a kick to the face.
Senton!
Heads outside, but this one has to end in the ring. Good timing with that reversal.
Oh, my
God, what an elbow.
What a suplex.
And there's Dragunov being greeted with yet another attack.
This is Cruz reminding everyone of the fighting spirit he possesses.
Oh, and he answers back on Cruz. Oh. He's returning fire.
Stomp in the leg.
Big risk here. He may.
He might be oblivious to the count, guys.
Climbing to the top rope.
Top rope!
Lose Del Toro 450. Del Toro putting all those tools to good use.
Really making the move.
Guys, can you believe how great that match was?
Major upset. Major upset. Hang on a minute. Oh, my God. From bad to worse. Oh, my God. Fuck it, I'll demolish him. Exciting end to a pretty mediocre card, to be fair. It took the last couple of matches to perk it back up a little bit. All right, guys, we're going to go drop another raid. Let's have a look where we're going. Who is streaming from WWE today? Let's have a look. We're not playing WWE, mate, so. Nope, no, I'm really playing WWE. Let's have a look at what we've got on the recommended. If not, guys, I'll be just reading a normal channel, like, I suppose. Show me some love to the guys who we've already read it before. Nothing really interesting to look at here so far. I don't read games that I've not played either, that I want to play at least anyway. We're going to read something called Sue Knight 92, play Assassin's Creed Valhalla, why not? Okay, guys. Well, next show's going to be CWF. You'll be catching that, if you're watching it on demand, the day after this, when this, of course, gets released. Or it'll be within the next 15 to 20 minutes. Have yourself a lovely day, evening, morning, wherever you are in the world, guys. And take it easy, and I'll see you when I see you.